Phase 1 Media Pro allows you to output your images directly from the program. If you're using TIFFs or JPEGs or PSD files, then Media Pro will output the file and it'll look just like you expect it to. If you're using RAW files and you're editing your images with Capture One, you need to make sure that your preferences are set in Media Rendering to Phase 1 as the preferred engine, and this needs to be unchecked. If you're using Adobe software and you're saving your files as DNG, you can also get a proper looking output, but you need to make sure that this is checked. Okay, so let's see what kind of options we have for output here. The first one we'll take a look at is print. If I want to create a contact sheet of a set of images, it's really easy. I go up to File and then Print. Within the Print dialog, I have a number of different options here. The grid gives me the ability to change the number of images that are on the page. I can choose to show or hide those background colors. If you're printing on inkjet, you almost certainly don't want to use the dark background. You can also set up a header as we see here, and we do that by hitting the header. Simply type in the information that you want to show here. These ampersand D are instructions that are found in the special menu that tell the program to fill in some information here, such as the date and the page number of total pages. And when we come back in here, we can see that it shows, pulls the date out, and it pulls out that correct page information. You'll notice that this is showing the label color and the stars, and that's because that's the way that the thumbnail view is set in Media Pro. I'm going to hit Cancel, and let's make these a little bit bigger, and you'll see that that's what's showing in here. So if we were to hide that information, and I'll go into View Options, and I'm going to not show the ratings and labels. Now when we go back into the Print dialog, we'll see that the ratings and labels are not showing. So you see those have disappeared. You can create a preset and save it in your View Options. I've got one here set for Contact Sheet, so that when you go into the Print dialog, it's going to show you the information you want to see. At this point, you can print and send it to your printer. On Macintosh, you can also send it off as a PDF directly from the Media Pro window here. Media Pro also enables you to create web galleries that can either be sent off on disk or can be uploaded to the web and provide a way to proof or show or share images. Each of these web galleries has several components in common. There's always a title, and then there's always a thumbnail page, and then when you select on the thumbnail page, you go to what's called the media page. And these are all built so that you have a next button, a previous button, and then an index button that takes you back to the main page. Let's take a look at how we create these. The command to create HTML galleries is in the Make menu, and it will always be running on whatever images are currently showing, not just what's selected. So I have 15 items showing, 5 are selected. If I ran it on this, it would still run on all 15. In the HTML gallery interface, we have the place to put the title in, and then you have the ability to choose a theme. These are the themes that come with Media Pro, and you can also create custom themes, as I have done right here. The one that we were showing earlier is this one. You have the ability to decide how many images show up on the index page and how big those thumbnails are. You can also decide how big the main media page is, how big that image is on the main media page. Here in the settings menu, you can decide whether you what the quality is that you'd like to use, whether you want to use a watermark, and then some metadata options here as well. You also have the ability to tell it to upload to your server, and you put the IP address of your server, your username and password, and the directory you want it to go to. Fill all of that out, and once it's finished making the gallery, it can automatically upload it. Like many places in Media Pro, we have the ability to save configurations we like as option sets. I have one that I use for pretty much everything, which uses this custom gallery. And essentially, once you have this all plugged in, then you hit the make button, you tell it where you want it to go, and I suggest creating a web galleries folder inside a drop folder, and hit create, and then we tell it to choose, and it's going to go ahead and build this whole gallery and then launch the web browser and show it to me once it's done. And here's the end result using my custom template that looks like the rest of my website. The slideshow also works on all items that happen to be showing at a given time, and it starts on whichever image is the selected image. We find the options up here in the Make menu. You can specify the duration of each slide, what color is in the background, what kind of transition it uses, and how it scales. In most cases, scale to fit's probably the right one. And then you can also set up how many images are showing at any given time, and you can even create a custom grid where you move these images around and you make them different sizes. And then down here at the bottom in these playback options, interactive means that you have to hit the mouse button or the arrow key to move on to the next slide. Continuous is just going to keep running. Random is going to not show the images in order. And if you've got voice annotations in your image files, it'll play them. Play sound from all movies will play multiple movie sounds at once if you have multiple movies showing on the screen at the same time. And fade in is how it starts up. I'm going to have it show the controller so we can see a little bit more information when we start this show. I can either hit OK and then go back and run it from the main menu, or I can just tell it to go starting right here. You can see that when we have the controller showing, it shows us which image we're looking at, and we also have the ability to play it and pause it. And when we're looking at it in this view, we have the ability to set custom time durations, custom transitions, custom scaling, and custom number of images on the screen, all from here in this dialog. And if you get this set up, you can save it. So for instance, if you wanted to linger on an image, you could do that, or have multiple images show at the same time. In most cases, I don't have this showing, and I simply look through my images using the arrow keys to move forward. I'm going to hit escape to get out of this, and let's take a look at one or two other features that we have here. If you'd like to have an audio file play during the slideshow, all you have to do is make sure you've got it at the front of the slideshow, and when you tell the slideshow to play, it's going to start playing it. And you can do the same thing with movie files. You just put it in the order that you want it to appear, and when you run the slideshow, the movie will show up and play. You can also export your slideshow as a movie, and you have some control over the settings here, but keep in mind that this is not really an animation program, and any timing that you're seeing on the automatic continuous playback when you're playing it back from Media Pro is not necessarily what you're going to see in the movie output. And finally, you have the ability to take one or more selected images and to convert these into some other different kind of format. So you have choices of these formats. You have the ability to resize your image or to keep it at the original size. You have the ability to change, in this case, since we're in JPEG, the amount of JPEG compression, or change it to a grayscale file. And then you have the ability to change the resolution of the file. Down here, we have the same output options that we saw in the HTML gallery. You have the ability to preserve color profiles, which you want to do, and then to keep or strip various kinds of metadata, as well as setting some kind of watermark on the image. Once you get things set up the way you like, you should create an option set so that next time you come back and need to do that kind of conversion, it's simply one click away.